Hi everyone, Jeremy here from RoboDK. Today we are going to talk about our plugin for Alphacam. As you may know, Alphacam is a CAM software, so a computer-aided manufacturing software which allows you to create CNC program and stuff. But now they have a new feature. You can create machining project using an industrial robot. We are going to take a look at that today. So, let's start by opening Alphacam. Here we have the victory statue, and we want to replicate the middle portion of it. So what we did in Alphacam is to project a pad on the surface, and this pad is going to be used as our machining pad for the robot. I'm not going to show you how to do that part. We are going to concentrate on the transition between Alphacam and RoboDK and the settings inside RoboDK. So when the pad is done, you're gonna look for the machining tab right here and for the robot integration options right there. First, click on robot integration settings and you are going to be able to select in RoboDK a station that you already created. Here I created a simple station using a KUKA KR210 and a spindle, so pretty basic stuff. I'm go back in Alphacam and I can select the station, and my measurement are in metric, and I want to export the tool. Here we selected a ball end 20mm tool. This option was implemented in the Alphacam pad, so it will be exported with the project in RoboDK, so no need to worry about that part. Next step, I'm gonna click on robot integration, and that window here is asking you to save your robot project. In fact, it's creating a copy of the empty station that we use, plus the new object, plus the path to follow. So it's just a copy of everything. I can save that, and now we can go back in RoboDK. Here we have our station and the statue that we want to machine. So the Alphacam plugin already implemented a few things in our station. So first of all, it brought with it the ball end 20mm tool. It also brought the part and it created a robot machining project and two robot programs. So first one is the robot machining project, and the second one is a main. So here the first one and this the second one. For the moment, the main only calls the machining project. And if we add many portions to do one after the other, or if we add many other programs to generate, we could call them all into the main in a certain order. So now if we take a look at the robot machining window just right here, there are a few interesting things to see. First of all, we have the KUKA here, and we also have the tool just right here. There, Alphacam took care itself of the approach and retract of the machining path, so we don't really have to take care of that in that situation. But if we wanted, we could have add some approach and retract using the two little window that are just here. So now let's see what our project look like for the moment. So if I click update and I click simulate, we can see that we are following the path and we are doing what it's supposed to do, but let's be honest, it's not really pretty. It's really glitchy, it's really buggy, and in real life it wouldn't do a great job. So we're gonna have to fix that. So let me press on escape to stop the simulation. Here we go. Now let's click on show estimated tool. That created a bunch of green spindle. This means that our path is for the moment reachable in all points by our tool, which is pretty good. But in the case where our part would be further away, so just like that, if I re-click on show estimated tool, you can see that now we have a bunch of red spindle. This means that the part is now unreachable on all those specific position and that we would need to move the part. So we're gonna put the part back where it was before, where we know we can work on it. And I'm gonna re-update that and re-update the project. And I'm going to re-simulate it. And now we have the exact same things that we had a few seconds ago. So let's press escape again. Okay, one thing we need to know before going further is that most CNC and machining projects are built for 3 or 5 axis systems. But with industrial robot, you always have 6 axis to work with. Considering that, one of the axis won't be used, and in that case, it's the rotation around Z of the tool. So, which is the blue arrow just right here. Even if the x-axis was upside down, pointing downward, it wouldn't change anything to the cutting path. The tool will follow the path in the exact same way. So if I change the tool orientations, let's just activate the show estimated tool path so it's easier to see the difference afterward. If I change the rotation to maybe a 180 degree, so you can see that a few tools change orientation. We have literally just rotated around the Z axis of the tool. So if I update the path and click on simulate, we can see that the path is followed in another direction, but it's not better. So we still need to do some work on that. Okay, I'm gonna put that back to 0 and I'm gonna escape the simulation and I'm going to update those. And now I'm going to click on the little blue plus here and those options appear. RoboDK manage path orientation in a certain way. So we need to have a preferred tool position for the x-axis of the tool in reference to the x-axis of the robot. Here with the default settings, we try to match the x-axis of the tool with the x-axis of the robot. So tool with x-axis of the robot. But in that case, it's pretty difficult because that would mean to machine from top to bottom if we want to have the x-axis right here. But we also want to have the z-axis always along the normal of the path. So we are going to need to work a bit on those two. So if I enlarge the reference so we see better, it would be nice if the x-axis of the tool would stay along the z-axis of the robot base. We have a button just right here saying that their preferred tool x-axis would be along the Z plus of the robot. And honestly, this is exactly what we want. So if I do that, and I simulate it, we can now see that we have a completely fluid and interesting path, which is very good. Okay, cool. That seems good. I'm going to escape. And from that, I can continue using the slider to make sure that every single point is reachable and to make sure that we don't have any weird behavior along our path. This is honestly pretty good. So I'll bring back my robot to the home position. And I'll simulate it again to make sure that we don't have a collision when we do the approach and retract. Okay, perfect. Let's escape. So we don't have any collision because, like I already said, Alphacam already took in charge the approach and retract from our path. So we come here and we go down along the Z axis and on the robot, and then we go sideways to the starting point of the path, and then we retract again and we go up along the Z axis. So in a situation where we would still need to avoid a collision, we could just add new approach and retract using those little two windows. Another thing to keep in mind is that you need your spindle to actually spin. So if you want to cut material, you need a spinning spindle. If you don't, you're gonna break the tool, break your spindle, or even break the robot, which is not good. In general, activating a spindle is pretty much just activating an output. So to do so, we are going to press on the program even button. So just right here. The event window will pop up just right here. And we can see that we have the path start and path finish that are activated. That means that when the path will start, we can activate an output. And when the path finish, we can deactivate it. So here, I'm going to call those spindle on and spindle off. Okay, perfect. Honestly, that don't mean anything for the moment and the robot won't really understand. It's more to show you guys how it works. So you would just need to put the right input for your personal project right here. So if I do that and okay, if I click on okay and update the project and perfect, close that, I can simulate it. And here there won't be any difference because the only thing we did was adding the rotating spindle, which won't show on the UI. Now I can go on the machining project and re-update it so the little exclamation mark right here disappear. And I can go afterward on the Cooker Robot, right click and find the post processor. We need to be sure that we use the right one for our robot. So here we have a new model of the Cooker line. So the KRC4 is perfect. Now I'm going to right-click on the robot program and I'm going to click on generate program. So now we have a notepad window just appear. This contains all our programs. So if I click here, first window will contain all the headers needed for the Cooker robot to work. And if I go down, we can see that we have pretty much everything and all our targets to reach. There is a bunch of target. And here we have our spindle on subroutine call. So this is where your IO would be activated to start the spindle rotation. So if I continue to the second window, there's pretty much only targets to reach. Same here for the third one. And here, the last one, a lot of targets to reach again. And if we go down there, we have the spindle of a subroutine call, which would stop the spindle from rotating. Okay, that's pretty much everything for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, subscribe to our YouTube channel. I'll be posting tutorial on a bunch of stuff related to RoboDK and its new feature. And if you want us to cover a topic in particular, put it in the comment section of this video. I'll be looking at that in the future. And finally, if you have technical questions about RoboDK, please visit our forum where the community will be more than happy to help you with your project. That being said, have a good day, guys.